I'm Martha Faller, and I want to let you know about the Navy's Ombudsman Program. I'm one of two ombudsmen working for the Chief of Naval Operations, the CNO. We are referred to as the CNO's Ombudsman at Large. Our job is to travel to the locations where we have Navy families, spend time talking with spouses, sailors, and fellow ombudsmen, and learn about the challenges they're experiencing at their location. We bring back that information and share it with our CNO, which he in turn takes for action. Our CNO cares deeply about our families and wants to know what he can be doing to help alleviate their concerns. My favorite aspect of being the Ombudsman at Large is the opportunity to spend time with other spouses, sailors, and other ombudsmen. It's an honor and a privilege to be in a position to interact with so many amazing people. I return home after every trip inspired by the resiliency of our families and humbled by all that I learn. The Navy Family Ombudsman Program is a Navy-wide program established to improve mission readiness through improved family readiness. Every command is instructed to have an ombudsman. Ombudsmen are a key and critical part of our Navy's unit readiness. Without good family readiness, our Navy cannot have good combat readiness. Our Ombudsman Program helps ensure that commanders and commanding officers have a better understanding of the welfare of the families in their command. The Ombudsman is that critical link between the command and its families. In addition, the Ombudsman Program assists commands and their families to be better prepared to meet emergency situations. A strong ombudsman program, both ashore and afloat, will ensure that our families have the information necessary to meet the challenges of a military lifestyle. Ombudsmen are parents, some work full-time jobs, some homeschool. I would like people to remember that our ombudsman volunteers lead busy lives, in addition to caring for and advocating for our command families. They deserve support from the command so they can properly do their job. Volunteering in this role is extremely rewarding. Ombudsmen have a giving heart and a passion for helping others. The reward is knowing that you are that critical link providing help to someone in need, that you made a difference for someone.
Military music and Navy band Great Lakes has a long, rich history. The first musician, a bugler, arrived in 1908 to the then new Naval Training Center, and the band was officially established in 1911 when the first recruits arrived for training. During World War I, the illustrious John Philip Sousa led the band as he trained more than 1,500 musicians for the Navy. Today's members carry on that noble tradition in the spirit of their motto, Pride in Service. With a wide range of performing ensembles, this talented group of professional military musicians appear in hundreds of parade, concert, school, public, and recruiting performances throughout its 11-state area each year as the Navy's ambassadors to the Midwest. The commander, Naval Service Training Command, Admiral Stephen C. Evans, is proud to present the men and women of Navy Band Great Lakes.
Thank you.
The drum major for today's concert is musician second class Christopher Bettler, and conducting Navy Band Great Lakes is chief musician Daniel Bethel. Another acknowledgement, please, for their outstanding performance this morning. Your sailors have not been permitted to smoke during training and are not permitted to do so while on weekend liberty. Regardless of their age, they are also prohibited from driving vehicles or consuming alcohol. Graduates who violate these rules will have the remainder of their liberty revoked and will incur a setback in training. Please support your graduates in meeting these important requirements so you and the Navy's newest sailors may share in a safe and enjoyable weekend in Chicagoland. Here is a special announcement for our guests of graduating Division 912. Your performers will need a few extra moments to return their equipment following the ceremony. After Liberty has been called, we recommend that the guests of Division 912 wait in your bleacher area and your graduates will join you shortly. Your patience is greatly appreciated. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, due to the design of our bleachers, it is almost impossible to retrieve small items that may fall between them during the ceremony. However, if items are dropped, please contact the Lost and Found following the ceremony. The parade of graduates is underway and will arrive at Midway Ceremonial Hall in just a few moments. Please make sure that all personal items are clear of the aisle and the drill deck. Guests in the balcony are reminded that standing along the rail is prohibited for the remainder of the ceremony. We know that your sailors will have many wonderful and amazing stories for you about their boot camp experience. However, at this time, we offer some video evidence that reveals our side of the story.
Good morning. I'm Rear Admiral Stephen Evans, Commander, Naval Service Training Command, and I welcome you to Naval Station Great Lakes and Recruit Training Command for recruit graduation. While this occasion is a chance for you to celebrate your loved one's graduation from our Navy's only boot camp, it is also a celebration of your impact on them as well. Throughout our nation's history, the steadfast support of military families has always been a source of inspiration to all who serve. Your sons, daughters, wives, husbands, and friends had other options than volunteering to serve their country. Yet they chose this path. And I join a grateful nation in saying thank you. None who serve stand alone. And the young men and women who graduate today owe much of their current and future success to family and the outstanding support you provide. I wish to extend my heartfelt thanks to each and every one of you who do so much for our Navy family. You are true patriots in so many ways, and your support makes a tremendous difference. You define us, you sustain us, you encourage and reinforce us. So enjoy today's graduation and take pride in this special occasion. I can assure you that this is a day you and our Navy's newest sailors will never forget. Again, my most profound thanks for your support and my most sincere welcome to our Navy family. Welcome aboard.
Thank you. As the parade of graduates approaches, we salute the states and territories whose sons and daughters will graduate today.
Delaware.
Pennsylvania. New Jersey.
Georgia. Connecticut. Massachusetts.
Maryland.
South Carolina.
New Hampshire.
Virginia. New York.
North Carolina. Rhode Island. Vermont.
Kentucky. Tennessee. Ohio. Louisiana. Indiana.
Mississippi.
Illinois. Alabama. Maine. Missouri.
Arkansas. Michigan.
Florida. Texas. Iowa. Wisconsin.
California. Minnesota.
Oregon. Kansas. West Virginia. Nevada. Nebraska.
Colorado. North Dakota.
South Dakota. Montana. Washington.
Idaho.
Wyoming. Utah.
Oklahoma.
New Mexico. Arizona.
Alaska.
Hawaii. District of Columbia. Puerto Rico.
Guam.
American Samoa. Northern Mariana Islands. Virgin Islands.
State flags. Order. Arms. And now we invite you to join the staff of Recruit Training Command in welcoming the graduating divisions with your applause as they enter Midway Ceremonial Hall and are announced in the following order.
Please welcome Division 051. Division 052. Division 053. Division 054. Division 055. Division 056. Division 057. Division 059. Division 060. Today's graduating performing unit is Division 912. Division 912 provides the arrival honor staff, honor guard, the recruit review commander, adjutant, and graduates who provide support assignments for today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, you may be seated. Thank you. Divisions. Right. Face. Section leaders, fall out and collect outer garments. Divisions, counter. March. Divisions, halt.
Prepare for review. At a normal interval, dress left, dress. Ready, front, left, face. At a close interval, dress right, dress. Ready. Front, right, face. Parade, rest.
May I have your attention, please? For the remainder of the review, no one will be permitted to pass in front of the review stand, and we ask this as a courtesy to our reviewing officer. Photography is certainly encouraged, but we ask that you remain seated and off the drill deck. The photographers you will see on deck throughout the review are the official photographers of Recruit Training Command. Division commanders, left or right, face, parade, rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am Lieutenant Ian DeSoto, Recruit Training Commander's Drill Division Officer. Today you will see 11 divisions comprised of 830 sailors participate in their graduation ceremony and soon join the most powerful Navy in the world. The unit position at center deck is the review commander and staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Seaman Dillian LeCount from Winter Haven, Florida. Performing and graduating today are the staff unit on their eighth and final week of training, the state flags unit on their seventh week of training, and the triple threat unit on their sixth week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During their night of arrival, all the recruits are placed into divisions of 88 personnel and assigned their division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are the key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves out as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and behavior. Each division also has a recruit chief petty officer. This is the senior recruit who supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief petty officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flags that they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief petty officer, the flag representing their home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will be starting from their right. Division 0-5-1. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Andrew McCord. Petty Officer First Class Timothy Reed. Petty Officer First Class Reuben Fletcher. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Leonardo Gonzalez from Manatee, California. Division 0-5-2. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Michael DeCary. Petty Officer First Class Joseph Sperry. Petty Officer First Class Cameron Venn. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Greg Gabriel from Brawley, California. Division 0-5-3. Commanded by Senior Chief Petty Officer Dan Sarau. Petty Officer First Class Jarrett Holcomb. Petty Officer First Class Nicholas Abbott. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Cody Myers from Gig Harbor, Washington. Division 0-5-4. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Joe Mendoza. Petty Officer First Class Thorin Maba. Petty Officer First Class Christopher Collins. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Marvis Adams from Memphis, Tennessee. Division 0-5-5. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Carol Williams. Petty Officer First Class Desiree Overton. Petty Officer Second Class Christopher Preston. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Jocelyn Marty from Springfield, Massachusetts. Division 0-5-6. commanded by Chief Petty Officer Rodaliza Atienza. Petty Officer First Class Marcus Crenshaw. Petty Officer First Class Latoric Portis. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Brendan Myrick from Beaumont, Texas. Division 0, 5, 7. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Kelly McAvoy. Petty Officer First Class Brian Gaw. Petty Officer Second Class Angela Howard. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Mitchell Bricky from Yorba Linda, California. Division 0, 5, 8. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Kelly Rixey. Petty Officer First Class Jordan Barrett. Petty Officer Second Class Aaron Mulholland. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Brendan Riggs from Detroit, Michigan. Division 0, 5, 9. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class David Nutt. Petty Officer First Class Joseph Barnes. Petty Officer Second Class Tasha Cruz. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Kiana Guadarrama from Del Rio, Texas. Division 0, 6, 0. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Wilkin Garcia. Petty Officer First Class Michael Milton. Petty Officer Second Class Jessica Goebel. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Adrian Walker from Burleson, Texas. Division 9, 1, 2. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Salvador Tapia. Petty Officer First Class Christian Zanin. Petty Officer First Class Eric Allen. And their Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Dillian LeCount from Winter Haven, Florida. On behalf of the commanding officer and staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these division commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. In a moment, you will see the ceremonial side boys, bosun, and honor guard take their places for arrival honors. This time-honored tradition is our formal greeting to this morning's reviewing officer. When requested by the announcer, please stand for the arrival honors, marching honor of the colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. Military guests shall remain covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As befitting the importance of this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony by letting your applause show your sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Thank you.
divisions. Attention!
Will the guests please rise and remain standing for the arrival of the official party? Recruit Training Command arriving. Naval Service Training Command, arriving. Commander, Expeditionary Strike Group 2, arriving. The guest may be seated.
Thank you. Color Guard! Hooray! The colors!
Will the guests please rise? Hand salute. And salute. Ready to. Chaplain Kearns will offer this morning's invocation.
Let us pray. Almighty God, receive into thy protective care these men and women who are about to go forth to defend justice and freedom as members of the United States Navy. Give them strength to meet every trial, courage to face every danger. Teach them to give and not to count the cost. To fight and not to heed the wounds, to work and not to seek reward, that they may wear with honor the uniform of their country and serve it worthily. These things we pray. Amen.
Our guests may be seated. At this point, the commanding officer would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. Then, the unit commanders would face about and relay the information to their divisions. Today's events demonstrate how orders are passed through the chain of command.
Divisions! Report! Very well. 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 Very well.
Division 912, all prisoners accounted for, sir.
Very well. All divisions, prisoners accounted for, sir.
Very well. The sailors creep.
Good morning, Captain. I present the graduating divisions. Request permission to commence the review.
Very well. Commence the review.
Aye, aye, sir.
Thank you. morning. I'm Captain Mike Garrett, commanding officer of Recruit Training Command. I welcome you to this morning's recruit graduation ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, this is where our Navy heritage meets the future, and where these young men and women enter the profession of arms. Division 912 graduates today. They are the staff unit, providing a rival honor staff, honor guard, recruit review commander, adjutant, and support for the ceremony. Let's give them a hand for their outstanding performances. Welcome to our reviewing officer, Rear Admiral Roy Kitchener, Commander, Expeditionary Strike Group 2, and Rear Admiral Stephen Evans, Commander, Naval Service Training Command. I would also like to welcome and recognize the veterans in our audience for their service to our country. Would our veterans please stand? I am pleased to welcome the families and friends of these graduates who have come here today to share the significant milestone with our newest sailors. The men and women of Recruit Training Command are dedicated to providing the United States Navy basically trained, physically fit, and smartly disciplined sailors like those whom you see before you. They, and others like them, serve as the bedrock of our naval forces. They give our Navy its combat edge, and they enable us to keep this nation secure. These sailors have successfully completed 8 weeks of demanding recruit training. They have recently demonstrated their courage, their knowledge, and their ability to form a cohesive fighting unit during battle stations. They have earned the right to wear the uniform recognized throughout the world as a symbol of freedom. This training group is ready to graduate and serve in the world's most powerful Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you 830 of the newest and sharpest sailors in the United States Navy.
Recruit Training Command's competitive system among individual recruits and divisions promotes teamwork, attention to detail, and pride in accomplishment. Divisions performing above standards throughout their training are awarded recognition flags in the following mission areas: academic achievement, military drill, compartment readiness, and physical fitness. These flags are carried as a visible symbol of the division's success. Each flag indicates that your sailors individually and as teams met performance standards in one or more mission areas.
Parade! Rest!
Rear Admiral Kitchener will now present this week's individual awards, and he'll be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Garrick, and Naval Service Training Command, Rear Admiral Evans. It is our pleasure to recognize the review commander for today's ceremony, Fireman Dillian LeCount, Division 912, from Winter Haven, Florida. Throughout his training, Fireman LeCount has exhibited great pride in the naval service and has consistently demonstrated his potential as an effective leader. He has maintained a high standard of personal appearance and an excellent display of military bearing and command voice. Congratulations on your outstanding achievement. Well done, sailor. For achieving the highest overall academic score during recruit training, Airman Dylan Botts, Division 051 from Taft, California, has earned the Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the Lake Defiance Chapter of the Illinois Society of the Sons of the American Revolution. Airman Botts receives a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. For having displayed extraordinary qualities best expressing the American spirit of honor, initiative, and loyalty, Seaman Ronaldo Bonifacio, Division 051 from National City, California, is awarded the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Seaman Bonifacio is presented with a commemorative plaque and a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Seaman Yvonne Nguyen, Division 055, from Harvey, Louisiana, is the winner of the United Service Organization Award for best exemplifying the spirit and intent of the word shipmate. Seaman Nguyen is given a commemorative plaque from the United Service Organization. Well done, sailor. Airman Nicholas Watson, Division 058, from West Palm Beach, Florida, is the recipient of the Military Order of the World Wars Award of Merit. This award is presented for meritorious performance during recruit training. Airman Watson is presented with a commemorative plaque from the Military Order of the World Wars. Well done, sailor. The Military Officers Association Leadership Award is presented to Airman Matthew Wells, Division 058, from Anniston, Alabama, for demonstrating exceptional tenacity and professionalism. Airman Wells is given a letter of commendation from our commanding officer. Well done, sailor. Airman Christian Mendoza, Division 058, from Greenwood, Indiana, is the recipient of the Navy Club of the United States of America Military Excellence Award for best exemplifying the qualities of enthusiasm, devotion to duty, military bearing, and teamwork. This award places him at the pinnacle of today's newest sailors. He is awarded a flag letter commendation. Airman Mendoza, the staff of Recruit Training Command, salutes you as the finest of this group of graduates. Well done, sailor!
divisions! Attention!
It is appropriate to recognize such outstanding individual accomplishments by these sailors with a round of three cheers. The adjutant will lead all graduating divisions in three cheers for this morning's award winners.
Hip hip! Hip hip! Hip hip!
I have the distinct pleasure this morning of introducing our reviewing officer, Rear Admiral Roy Kitchener. Rear Admiral Kitchener commands Expeditionary Strike Group 2, a potent amphibious force comprised of both U.S. Navy and U.S. Marine Corps units that delivers power projection ashore and rapidly responds to global crises in execution of our national maritime strategy. A native of Trumbull, Connecticut, Admiral Kitchener earned a Bachelor of Arts in Political Science from Unity College, Maine in 1984. He also earned a Master of Arts in National Security Affairs, specializing in Western Hemisphere Area Studies. He began his naval career at the Naval Officer Candidate School, Newport, Rhode Island, where he was commissioned in 1985. A career surface warfare officer, Rear Admiral Kitchener has served at every level of operational command, including afloatators as executive officer aboard USS Cowpens and operations officer and chief of staff for Commander Carrier Strike Group 11. He commanded two guided missile destroyers, USS John Paul Jones and USS Higgins, as part of the Navy's Sea Swap Initiative, as well as the guided missile cruiser, USS Princeton. Ashore, he has served on the staff of the Chief of Naval Operations, instructed at the Surface Warfare Officer School, and directed ballistic missile defense operations in the Cheyenne Mountain Directorate. Additionally, he has been Chief of Staff to Commander U.S. 3rd Fleet and Commander Naval Surface Forces. He was the Vice Commander of Naval Mine and Anti-Submarine Warfare Command and Chief of Staff of Naval Striking and Support Forces, NATO. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a warm Recruit Training Command welcome to an outstanding sailor, Rear Admiral Roy Kitchener.
Well, good morning, everyone, and thanks for that great introduction. It's really a privilege to join all of you here today to celebrate this tremendous accomplishments of these young men and women who stand before us and welcome them as sailors into the world's finest Navy. For over a century, Naval Station Great Lakes has transformed over 3 million civilians into highly trained sailors. This morning, I don't want to speak about those who have gone before us, because it's really about this group of sailors, about these young men and women who have made a decision to join the profession of arms and have earned the distinction of being part of something that is bigger than them and something that is noble. They've been on this journey for some time already. They took a trip down to the recruiter. They went down to the MEPS, which makes sure they're all medically fit to come here. And then finally, they came to RTC. But the journey goes on. In fact, I would submit to you, the best part is just about to begin. I know there's a bunch of you out there that are on this drill deck that remain anxious or uncertain about what's coming next. And perhaps you're still wondering, my goodness, what on earth did I get myself into? I have to be honest with you, there are days when I still ask myself that question. So when you see these sailors or any servicemen, when you're out and about and after this ceremony today, make sure you tell them. They really have gotten themselves into something that is both courageous, honorable, and extremely rewarding. And please, don't forget to thank them and any servicemen you run into. There's a quote that I'm pretty fond of that always reinforces to me why I have committed my life to this profession. Edmund Burke, renowned for his support of the American Revolution, said, "The only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men and women to do nothing." Ladies and gentlemen, these sailors, as they stand in formation before you, are doing something. They're putting self-service above self. They're defending our way of life from those who would do us harm. They're honoring you and those who have gone before them. And they're sacrificing some of their own personal liberties to be part of something truly special. Today, your sailors are going to look different to you. Maybe they're a little bit more slender. Maybe they're a little bit more muscular. They're all definitely more poised and confident, and probably very relieved that this part of their journey is over. But I'd submit to you, all of them now understand how to put others before self, how to work together for a common and greater good. And they all embody a sense of personal ownership in themselves and their work. Today, we must also remind ourselves and thank the people that helped them on this journey. The recruit division commanders, instructors, and staff here at RTC have taken on the unique and honorable challenge of shaping recruits into the finest American sailors, maintaining the standards that make us the world's most powerful Navy. Thank you all at RTC here for helping produce these very best sailors. But most importantly today, I'd also like to thank the families and friends behind me of these sailors for the integral role you've played in developing them and helping them start this journey. You helped shape your recruit into a person who wanted to serve their country, who understands the Navy core values of honor, courage, and commitment. The importance of your role in their lives will only get greater as they immerse themselves in this profession. So please continue all that great support. Shipmates, sailors, you are about to embark on one of the most challenging adventures of your life. You've chosen to serve your country at a time when it is most needed, when America must continue to show a strong presence throughout the world. You've made a good choice. I'm a little bit biased, but I'd say it's the best choice. And you're now prepared to carry out that tremendous duty. So roll up your sleeves and get ready to work. You have earned not only mine, but the respect of a grateful nation. Congratulations, sailors. I'm proud to serve alongside all of you.
Drummers, post!
Rear Admiral Kitchener will now receive the salute of the graduating divisions, and he'll be joined on the drill deck by our commanding officer, Captain Garrick. Please remain seated until your graduates have been placed on liberty. Please join me in one more round of appreciation for our wonderful musicians of Navy Band Great Lakes. Flags. Post, section leaders fall out and retrieve outer garments. Midway's ceremonial drill hall will be closing at the conclusion of today's graduation. Please check the area around you to ensure you have all your possessions. For those families with strollers, please retrieve them as you exit the drill hall. Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy days. And without further delay, now hear this, Liberty Call, Fall Out!